Yep, definitely sick. Oh yes, must take the time to get the runes, as always, as almost always, as per usual. Seriously, I literally moved. Ugh. My bad. Definitely my bad. Falling to my death is not a favorite way of mine to die. I'm even standing here. Truly, I do not know. But it is very entertaining. There we have them. A boon charm. Twist of fortune. 1. Very rarely a potion gives you full mana. Void shell. Yeah, I need that damage from explosions. I don't need that. I like the sound of twist of fortune. Taking my time to go on this horrible journey through sickness and disease. Oh, will you now? No! No! I hate myself so much. I hate this game sometimes.
Why would you come back here?
Oh, good.
But we should watch the streets. We'll see him from the rooftops.
All right. If nothing else, we can cut him off at the market.
We can't get through the air station without the key.
This one is resourceful. You'll find a way.
Interesting. Hope I didn't break that. Whoop. And fill it up. Put it here. Ooh, the Greaves Whale House. In the early days, when the ships brought in the great dead whales, men would slaughter them and reduce their blubber to oil in massive vats on the banks of the Wren Haven. Small crews maintained their own vats, with workers specializing as fire tenders, slicers, gutmen, haulers, or strainers. Inevitably, once the demand went up, the businessmen moved in, wooing the best crews with promises of better pay and safer conditions. The warehouses went up at the edges of the Rothshore financial district almost overnight. None was more organized, or as some would say, more ruthless, than the Greaves Warehouse, opened by Ebenezer Greaves himself. The Greaves Warehouse grew rapidly, absorbing rivals until it dominated the trade. At its peak, the operation employed over 300 workers, not including the children who filled minor and often tragic roles. These associated with the refinery were recognizable by their head-to-toe industrial leather uniforms and the masks they wore to protect against fumes. Oh, so that's where they got their masks from. On hunting whales. Excerpt from a forward gaffer's journal by Old Grum. These new ships made by that Sokol fellow make life easier than it was in my youth. I'll tell you what. Here was. We were at the mercy of the winds. Winds. Now that the engines get up at the first whale sign and there ain't time enough to rouse the boys from their bunks afore you're on the hurt. We call out the biggest bastard we can lay eyes on, and the pilots drag us out from the circling brutes. Them things groan and bellow across the water like they're calling to each other. Men below say you can feel it in the hull. But when the harpoons go in, the beast cannot make for deep water no more. Once it weaks from lost blood, we launch the hook boat and put chains into the tail. Then the winches drag the bastard backward up the chute and into the rigging overhead. A lovely way to treat whales, I'd say. Just all around exceptional. Anyone else in need of a stabbing? A few coins, as if coins are going to matter soon enough. I have no idea what you are, but you look dreadful, my dear. Well, vivisection! Is this the whale episode? I do dare say it is. Excerpt from the notes of a natural philosopher aboard a whaling ship. Remarkably, each specimen I had the pleasure of studying during the voyage possessed some minor variance in physiology. On the second leg of the trip, east of Tivia, the crew hauled aboard a female, some 42 feet in length. I estimate she weighed 35 tons, and the ship sat low, rocking side to side through the night with her thrashing. By candlelight, I took her apart, sketching and taking notes. That must have been very impressive. Against her bellowing, I cut into the mass of tentacles around her mouth. Within, I found row upon row of teeth, and a baleen running along the upper jaw. Through this broom-like structure, I assumed she filtered food from the water that was too small to be chewed. Right. We're getting close now. Well, all processing. It is the well episode. Excerpt from the founder of the Greaves Warehouse by Ebenezer Greaves. Out at sea, they secure the beast with hooks, with lines cast from the main ship and from several smaller boats. Bios keep the whale from diving deep. Once it's caught, a larger hook is driven through the tail. Which is used to hoist the creature up through the chute. They moan and bellow for some time as the men get them onto the deck, then lift them into the scaffolding overhead. The ship adjusts its prow and returns to port in Dunwall, where the crew works on the great creature, slicing off the fattest parts while it still lives. Okay, this one is really an obvious solution to a problem. And you, boy, you didn't even notice this, did you? I do believe he was an overseer. An ex-overseer, obviously. I feel so much better now. Not worth it. Can I get all the way up? Whoops. Ouch. Alright, maybe this is not the way I get back up. Okay. And this was stupid. I keep doing stupid stuff. I'll just edit it out in post. Okay. Let's do this right now. I have no idea why I didn't do this in the first place. None. Okay, time to get down there. Alright, I had a plan. I thought I could blink twice mid-air, but obviously this did not work. And yes, once I'm done with this, I'm saving. Definitely saving. Now, I do want to take that out. I think I may be able to survive this. He said, and then pressed escape, and then he fell as he jumped, because he's an idiot. I'm having a particularly bad time right now. Alright, let's do this. Chains. Because sometimes you just have to die over and over and over again. Alright, let's save at this point, because I do not want to replay this again. Ever. Ever, ever, ever again. down, if you will. I wonder if I will die. Let's see. Nope. Whoa! Poisonous things. One out of five rooms. I have no idea what these things are, but they horrify me because of the sounds they make. Now, heart. Anything for me? No? Okay. Actually, what does the heart have to say?
They bring the bodies here with rough hands and pinches. Some of them are still breathing. Swan is so cold, and it is the last thing they feel.
I feel for them in turn. Let's see. These anything else?
Greedy. They will never give back what they have taken.
I bet that they will not. Anything else, Hart?
Even the terrible floods were not enough to wash away the sins of them.
Hey, guy. Here, let me help. Overseer's warning. The assassins sprung their trap as we tried to cross the narrow bridge. At that choke point, they were able to pick us off one by one. We thought we could draw them inside, where our greater numbers could make more of a difference. But it didn't matter. Now I'm the only one left alive, and I feel that slipping from me minute by minute. And I just was helping along. Please, if a second group attempts to come through this way, beware of that breach. They are listening for the sound of the door opening. Keep an eye on the rooftops. Even a small number of them is more than a match. Is there a way for me to pass from that point? No, I suppose not. Oh, very well. If they are listening, then I shall merely murder them all. Let us see what they have in store for me. I love how they've left swords all over the place. Just in case someone feels like, hey, I'm not gonna go and pick my stuff up. Oh, there's a note down there. Orders from High Overseer Campbell. I bid you safety and courage in your expedition. The assassin Dowd and his cultist followers are commonly known as the Wailers, due to their all worker masks they wear. Beware, for Dowd may possess power and resistance beyond expectation. Tread with extreme caution. Their infamy is well earned. They are based inside the Chamber of Commerce building in the ruins of the central Rothshaw. All roads to this area have been blocked, with the exception of the elevated rails. Find a rail station in the Rothshaw Market. March carefully, for the cultists undoubtedly employ spies to watch you up. Can't hurt me, evil plants. They probably can, but I'm not going to let them. So many grenades, pistols, and blades. Now show me where these foul assassins hide themselves. is how you do it. It's how you assassinate assassins. Let me reiterate. Damn it. This one was sloppy. Sloppy, unprofessional work. Not for a man of my caliber, certainly. Too late. Too bloody late. Time to go. Let's see. Will doubt prove as much a threat as, you know, taking the chain up and down did? Small-scale combustion refinement. Oh, lovely. Weapon courier's message. Corwin. Imagine the firepower of a tallboy, but the speed and ease of concealment of a pistol. With this new technology, any soldier with a steady gun arm will be a force to be reckoned with. Make sure it gets to the Lord Regent without delay. Interesting. Not see me if I come from the depths below. Twelve meters.
Here, breathing in the rich stink of their enchanted flesh.
Okay, not the way to that room, I suspect. Healthy appetite, too. Is that another one where you eat rot? Oh! Cool. Not for me, because, you know, I rarely get stabbed, murdered and maimed, but useful nonetheless for all those gluttons out there. With the intricate art of assassinations. Whoa! But hey, I'm not failing in just murdering them straight out. That's good enough for me. Good enough. And I didn't even take all that much hell damage. Hell. Now the only thing I want to know is how the hell do I get to that room? Alright. Messy. That was the sound for a secret. I know that sound. I'm missing something now. I know it for sure. Let me take a more careful look. Above, perhaps? Nothing, no painting that has somehow survived the horrors of this horrible time. No, nothing. Well, obviously I'm missing something. Alright, you know what? I think I'm going to take a small pause right here. Thank you guys for watching. And I'll see you next time. Bye!